Welcome to part one. Here's where it begins. So we're going to design an electric piano. I already have a Fender Rhodes piano and a Wurlitzer electric piano, and I think these are going to heavily influence the design we come up with. I aim to make a video on each part of the piano, though I might revisit them and redesign them as the design progresses. I really hope this becomes a collection of ideas and inputs from anyone who wants to get involved. So the first part I'm going to make is a hammer. Why? Hammers are cool. And who doesn't like hammers? So there's two routes we could go to designing the mechanism of the piano, and one's the Wurlitzer mechanism. This feels really good, it's really expressive, but it has lots of parts to it and a level of skill. Or the alternative is the Fender Rhodes approach. This is really simple and it's actually beautiful how simple it is, but the action doesn't quite feel so expressive, in my opinion anyway. So I'm going to go with the Fender Rhodes approach, and I'm going to look at the hybrid hammers that are inside my Fender Rhodes piano as a starting point. I know these hammers well, I know the weaknesses and strengths, so it helps me design a better hammer from the information we've got. This hammer works by, when the key's pressed, the pedestal of the key flicks the hammer into the tone generating elements of the piano. It's really simple. So does it have any issues? I'm going to say yes, it's got two. One is quality. So where the plastic and wood are glued together, these aren't always perfectly aligned, and this can create subtle differences between different notes. Also, these hammers are quite prone to wear. These pivot pins are very small and can wear out over time. This creates like a sloppy motion, and sometimes the key won't sound when you press. So to improve on this, I've come up with my own solid plastic design that can be 3D printed. I've increased the size of the pin to reduce any possible wear, and as it's all one piece, there's no alignment issues. Okay, let's print this design. Now I have complicated the design a little bit more than what I planned to by adding an extra part to the assembly. We've created a separate pin for the hammer, but this just helps with the assembly with it being 3D printed. So when designing parts for this piano, I've got three points I'm going to consider. The first one is availability. I want to use standard parts, standard materials that anyone across the world hopefully can get their hands on. The next one's cost. If there's a cheap way of doing something, that's the way I'm going to take, at least initially. And this will just help create something that's affordable, because the cost of these pianos is skyrocketing, and hopefully you can come up with something that's almost like a cheap kit to create your own, to get you started on this expensive drug of buying mechanical pianos. And the last point is just easy. I'm sure I could make something quite skillful, but it would take a lot of time and effort, and it's not necessary, so I really want something that anyone can manufacture. Well, at least that's a goal anyway. We'll see how it pans out. So this 3-point criteria, I expect to lead us to a very Fender Rhodes influenced design, but let's see. So this isn't the first print I've made of this. It took a few designs to get the pin to line correctly, but now it just taps in with a hammer. If I was to use this for an actual piano, I'd use a little bit of glue just to make sure that it doesn't come out with use. But this seems to move freely and fine, and compared to an actual Fender Rhodes hammer, it seems to respond just the same. If we put it on the scales, we can compare the weight of both. So the original hammer is 13 grams, and the new 3D printed design is also 13 grams. It's not a lot of difference between the two. I don't think we're going to noticeably feel it. Compared to the original, on first impressions, this new design seems very similar. I've missed a few features off the bracket that appears on the original design. If we need them, we can add them on later. And I've also changed the hammer slightly, just smoothing the geometry. The outline is very similar, and it would allow it to replace a hammer in a Mach 1, but I'm not going to come up with a design that actually does that. I think there's a lot of vendors out there that do a great job, and a 3D printed part isn't necessarily the way to go if you've got an actual classic instrument. The weight distribution of the hammer will be different. but I'm not sure how much of that will be noticeable once we put a striking tip on the hammer. Also, I quite like this colour. I think they look fantastic. But yeah, if you want to follow this project, do subscribe. Let me know what we should do next. I really do want some input from lots of people. So just let me know what you think. And look out for the next episode. Thank you.